Hi everyone. Here we are back again for our last Cooking Matters lesson. That went by quick. So in today's lesson, we're going to talk about physical activity, reading a nutrition facts label, and building a healthy meal. So what you'll need for today is a good set of running shoes, and you'll also need to be open-minded when we talk about our balanced meal. And I really want you to put your thinking caps on when we talk about reading a nutrition facts label. It is a very important skill to have, and your job is going to be to teach somebody that you live with about reading a nutrition facts label once we are done. So let's get started with today's activities. So let's talk about reading a nutrition facts label. The first thing you always want to look at is the servings per container. That's really important because of a lot of times we eat more than we should. I used this example in the last lesson. How many servings do you think are in this container of chocolate milk? If you remember correctly, there are two. A lot of us see this as a single serve container though. So when we look at the back, the sugars, there's 27 grams per one cup. Well, if you drink this whole container, there's two cups in here. So there's actually 54 grams. So it can be a little tricky if you don't know what you're doing. So always look at the servings per container. This particular example, there are two servings per container and the serving size is 1 1/2 cups. If you eat 1 1/2 cups, all of this information is correct. But if you choose to eat the entire package, all two servings, or 1 1/2 cups plus 1 1/2 cups is 3 cups, if you eat the whole thing, you'll need to double all of these numbers to get the appropriate nutrition facts. So if we've looked at the servings per container and the serving size, next we can look at calories. There are 240 calories in 1 1/2 cups of this food. Remember, if I eat the whole container, we need to multiply that by 2, which brings us up to what? You're right, 480. So calories are things that we need. Calories are units of energy for our body, but not all calories are created equal. For example, do you think the calories from 100% fruit cocktail, 100% juice fruit cocktail, and chocolate milk are the same? No, of course not. Here we have healthy, natural fruit calories. Here we have some good calories from milk, but also a lot of calories from sugar. So our better choice here and our better calories are probably going to be our fruit. There's a lot of examples like that. Think about an avocado versus a whoopie pie. Which one has better calories? Well, of course, the avocado does. So check out your calories and ask yourself, are these calories that will give me energy? Will these help me stay full and help me feel good? All right, the next thing you'd like to look at is going to be the percent daily value. I know that sounds confusing, but listen really, really carefully. When you're looking at your nutrients, such as total fat, saturated fat, trans fat, cholesterol, and sodium, these are all nutrients we want to make sure we're not getting too much of. Sodium is salt. Cholesterol is not very good for your heart. Trans fat is not good for you at all, and you always want that to be zero. Saturated fat also can be hard on your heart. And then total fat, we just need to make sure we don't get too much fat in our diet. Fat is healthy for you, but not in huge quantities. So if I ask you a question, what does 4 grams of fat look like? Do you know the answer to that? Well, I don't know. Does it look like a small handful? Does it look like something I should put on a scale and weigh? I'm not sure what 4 grams of fat looks like. So here's what I want to show you. If you look over here to the percentage instead, you'll see 5%. I'm just going to go ahead and grab a marker and grab a piece of paper. If I can find one, I have a pen. And a piece of paper right here. All right, so when you look at this, I'm gonna make it easier for us. We have 4 grams of fat, which is 5%. So out of 100% of the daily amount of fat you should eat, let's figure out what 5% looks like. So we follow a rule called the 5-20 rule. 5% being very low, 20% being very high. So we determined that in this food, if you eat one serving of it, you're getting 5% of the daily amount of fat you should get. So if I plugged 5% on my number line, would you consider this a high or a low fat food? You're right. It's a very low fat food because it's way down here by 5. Even if I ate the whole container, what's 5 times 2? Because remember, there's 2 servings here. 10? Well, even if I had to plug 10 in on my number line, is that high or low? You know what? It's still pretty low. It's kind of low to medium. So this is a very low fat food. Let's check out a different one. Saturated fat is 1.5 grams. Well, I don't know what that looks like, but I know that 8% would fall fairly low on this number line. So can I consider this a low fat, low saturated fat, or high saturated fat food? You're right, I can consider it low. If I ate 2 servings of this food though, 8 times 2 is what? Oh yeah, 16. 16's pretty high up there. So if I ate this whole container, am I getting a lot of saturated fat for 1 serving? Yeah, I'm getting 16% of my day. And if you think about 16% out of 100%, that's a little bit high. All right, let's check one more. Sodium. 430 milligrams of sodium. I don't know what that looks like. Well, I know what 19% looks like on my 5 to 20 number line. It looks like really, really high. So, whoa, if I eat 1 serving of this food, the sodium is all the way up at almost 20% of the amount of sodium I should have in a day. And remember, if I ate both servings, that 19 quickly turns into a 38. Oh my word, it would be like way down here. 38% of the amount of salt I should have in a day just from one food, that's too much. So does everybody understand how we can use the 5-20 rule to understand how much of a nutrient is in our food? Let's do a little bit more practice. Grab yourself a piece of paper and go grab a food from your refrigerator or from your pantry, something that has a label that looks like this. Go find it and I'll be right back. All right, I have chosen a bag of yellow corn tortilla chips. Whatever you have, I'd like you to follow along. Go ahead and find your nutrition facts label and first look at the serving size and the servings per container. Mine has 9 servings in this bag. The serving size is 1 ounce. So I have to picture this bag and say, could I eat chips out of here 9 times? Well, that's something I should think about because sometimes I wonder if maybe this is more like a 2 or 3 serving bag, but that's when it comes down to eating more food groups at one time. So if you decide to have these tortilla chips, you're having some grains. But maybe if you had an apple with it and some vegetable salsa, you'd fill your belly up quicker and you wouldn't have to eat quite so many. And then this would really be a 9-serving bag. All right, so now that we've looked there, we can check out our calories. 130 calories, that's not very many calories. The average adult needs about 2,000 calories a day, and it really depends on your activity level. It depends on your size and your gender. An average kid probably needs between 1,600 and 2,000, depending on what age you are. You can always look this up online. So 130 calories doesn't seem like too many, and if these are whole grain yellow corn tortilla chips, then that's an okay calorie, although these might be deep fried. We'll have to check. All right. So now we want to look at, let's look at fat. I have 7 grams of fat, which is 9%. So if I only ate 1 serving of these chips, then 9% isn't too bad on my 5-20 rule. But if I ate all 9 servings in this bag, I would get 81% of my daily amount of fat. That's almost 100%. That means I wouldn't be able to have much else that day. Let's check out our sodium. 55 milligrams. Sodium is salt. So 55 milligrams is only 2%. That's super small. And if I ate all 9 servings in this bag, it's 18%, which really isn't that bad considering how many chips that is. So this seems to be a very, very low salt, low sodium food. Ooh, dietary fiber, 2 grams is 7%. So wow, 7%. We actually want our dietary fiber to be higher. We want our fiber to be higher and all of our vitamins and minerals, vitamin D, calcium, iron, and potassium. We actually want those to be up over 20%. So some of our nutrients we want to be lower and some of our nutrients we want to be higher. The top 5, fat, saturated fat, trans fat, cholesterol, and sodium. We want all of those percentages to be low. And then some of the ones on the bottom, fiber, and all of our vitamins and minerals, we want to be nice and high. Carbohydrates and protein depend on your activity level. If you're someone who lifts a lot of weights, you need a lot of extra protein. If you're a marathon runner, you need a lot of extra carbohydrates. So think about what you do and think about how much protein and carbohydrates you need for energy and muscle building.